Hey, yo, welcome back to About My Money TV. This your boy King Chaos. As I always say, don't watch me, watch About My Money TV. I'm bringing y'all a little piece of local news, man. I'm trying to come and bring y'all something different on my channel. Bring y'all back to Nap, my hometown, where we have an Indianapolis man who worked for the CVS Pharmacy, man. Let's talk about this fool, man, for a second. Let me take y'all to the biggest distribution center in CVS, man, right off of 465 and 70. If you in Nap, you know what I'm talking about. This Indianapolis man is said to steal 1.5 million dollars worth of bottles of codeine. The man's name, or suspect, allegedly Jesse Holloway, was a supervisor for the CVS Pharmacy and had an entry card, and over several months period stole something in the area of, I want to say, the local news reports say he stole about 1,500 bottles of Promethazine with codeine, man. 16-ounce bottles. So if you a drinking man, we talking about this man stole 1,500 pints of that drink straight out of the CVS Pharmacy Distribution Center and went home every day and did it again and again. And he was checking in and out with his own security card. Now, this is what turns me off, is how retarded are you to use your card to go in and out and get these 1,500 bottles? Now, CVS is reporting that $1.5 million worth of codeine. That's they cost. We talking about street costs. If you take 1,500 pounds, I'm sorry, 1,500 pints of drink, let me slow that down with y'all again, bro. 1,500 pints of drink, and they only talking about 1.5 million. Man, let me tell y'all something. They only talking about $50 to $60 a line. Now everybody know that pure codeine going about $100 a line now. That's $100 a line times 16 times 1,500 pints. My math say street value on that is probably about $2.5 million hitting the streets. And I'm talking about good pure codeine straight from the CVS Pharmacy. Now CVS did flag his car and him going in and out of the facility, and of course they reported it to the Federal Bureau of Investigations and the United States Attorney, which acting attorney right now is a man by the name of John Childers, and you will be seeing his name across the screen. John Childers, in association with DEA, put out an APB on this man. They visited his home in Central Indiana, Indianapolis, where his roommate said that Mr. Holloway said he was going on vacation. Now, he was going on a long vacation because I wouldn't have been on my way back. But as he was on his way south or west on 465 and 70, on his way to New Mexico or on his way to Mexico, he was spotted. Now, I don't know if they really knew what this man did, but Mr. Holloway was driving. And as Mr. Holloway was driving, he was spotted by a DEA agent. The DEA agent was under a different drug. Excuse me. He was guarding a different drug. They was actually making sure that the pandemic or the flu shot was getting to the right people and was being processed and sent over the state lines and back and forth. And the DEA just spotted the car that the APB was out on and caught Mr. Holloway before he could get out of the country. I think he was right around New Mexico on his way south, man, to get up out of here. So I just want to kind of bring y'all this information, man. Again, Jesse Holloway is a alleged suspect in stealing over 1,500 pints of promethazine with codeine. If you a street cat like me and you can do the numbers, man, you know what I'm talking about, man. So not be getting it in, man. So this is just one story I'm going to be bringing y'all from my city, man. How we make it make sense and which way we make it make sense. But CVS Pharmacy, using your own swipe card to go in and out the facility, and you get caught. Of course you're going to get caught, my guy. This is nothing new. They know what you're using this for. And once you get up to that many bottles, at some point you should have been making sure you was using a different card. If you was truly a supervisor, you should have been trying to figure out a way to get to another card or created another associate's card to get yourself in and out the facility and not continue to use your own swipe card. They said, though, by the way, that the suspect did have a few pieces of paraphernalia, but none of the actual product within his home. But when he was apprehended, it's believed that he had the product in the vehicle with him as he was making his move through New Mexico. I'll be keeping y'all updated with any details and developments, but from what I can see, the federal prosecutors, along with the DEA and CVS, have recovered most of the drugs, and he did not distribute it throughout Indianapolis, which I guess was smart but ignorant at the same time. And you kept using your own swipe card. If I was Charlemagne the God, I'd probably be giving him Donkey of the Day, but we're gonna give him Naptown's Idiot Hustler of the Week. All right, man. Come back to About My Money TV if you like this content. I'll be trying to provide more of this content for you. I got a lot of nice stories coming about the streets of Indianapolis for you. Naptown, if you where I'm from. Shout out to all my other bloggers in the Midwest. Shout out to all my artists that I deal with out here, man. And be sure to visit bmnmerch.com for the clothing. And hit that like and subscribe button, man, if you like hearing what I'm talking about. Again, this is just a small video about a gentleman named Jesse Holloway that stole over 2.5 million. They reporting 1.2 million, but street value is double that. And again, like I always say, man, don't watch me, watch About My Money TV, and come back and holler at your boy again. And it's King Chaos that way.